from Hong Kong, China, to contest the men's singles final at this event. So a little bit of history made by Yi Cheng Yu. Well, as far as the men's singles draw was concerned, by the quarterfinal stage, we had four seeds only, two in each half, but seven different flags. That's always good to see. Wonderful that Pranoy, the home player, got through to the semi-final stage, where there was four different nationalities. The former champion, Shi Yu Qi of China, won the title here 6 years ago in 2018, beating Cheuk Yiu of Chinese Taipei in the final. A year ago, he lost in the second round to Victor Axelsen, who went all the way through to the final. And for Shi Yu Qi, a second final in 2 weeks, having lost in the final of the Malaysia Open. But here, the man making a little bit of history, Yi Cheng Yu of Hong Kong, China. His fifth appearance at the India Open. And prior to this year, he'd never progressed past the first round. He's had a staggering set of results, which I'll tell you more about in a moment, to get through to today's final. And beaten former champions, a former or a reigning world champion, an Olympic medalist, and a world championship medalist as well. Well, this will be a 10th meeting between these two players, and of the previous nine, Shi Yu Qi has the slight advantage, having won five of them. In fact, he's won the last two. The last time,
Lee,
was in the first round of the Asian Games.
You choose black or the golden side.
Three games, as
gold.
You can see.
Okay. Gold and black for you.
Minutes, to the top. Shi Yu Qi, who went on to take the silver medal.
Gold, that is. You choose. Decide.
So Shi Yu Qi
serve or receive.
The toss of the coin
serve.
And
thank you.
Chooses the near side of the court from which to start. Thank you to our guest who conducted the toss of the coin. Well, Shi Yu Qi will turn 28 next month. And he himself is a world championship silver medalist going back 6 years. He was winner of the All-Indian Championships in 2018 as well. That's silver at the recent Asian Games. He lost out to his teammate Li Shengfeng. Currently number two on the world ranking. It's his 53rd week in total. He went up four places on the rankings published earlier this week. Three games in his first round against teammate Wen Hongyang, the left-hander, then Rasmus Gemka, and then Watanabe in the semi-final against the Asian Games and World Championship bronze medalist Pranoy of India. Apart from his opening game, where he was fresh from travelling from Malaysia, he's played two games all the way since that first round. Yi Cheng Yu, 27 years of age, from Hong Kong, China, and 178 equates to 5'10". Two finals last year in Thailand and the event in Saarbrücken. Lost both of those finals, but looking at these results, he beat the former world number one and winner of this event, Kadambi Shrikan, in the first round. He won the event back in 2015. Then the reigning world champion and defending champion here, Widasan from
Ready
Thailand, he needed three games there. The Olympic bronze medalist, Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, and then the world championship silver medalist from last year, Kodai Naraoka. Time on court to get to this final, 4 hours, 38 minutes. As we look at our court officials for this one from Denmark and Germany.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Shi Yu Qi, China. And on my left, Li Cheuk Yiu, Hong Kong, China. Li Cheuk Yiu to serve, level play.
So the man making history, Li Cheuk Yiu of Hong Kong, China, getting this men's singles final underway against the former champion, Shi Yu Qi. Li Cheuk Yiu, not seeded. Good opening rally. That's a wonderful shot from Shi Yu Qi. And Steve, before we really get embroiled in this potentially very interesting men's singles final. Of course, our first three finals going to players from three different countries, and it means that we will definitely have the five titles going to players from five different countries. That's always nice, isn't it?
That is good with the competition.
The last time that happened was at the Singapore Open last year. Well taken. Well, both you and I thought Shi Yu Qi was looking exceptionally strong earlier in the tournament.
Yeah.
I think you and I, did we call his a Gemka match, or was it just me on my own calling that one?
No, I think that's someone as well. I can't recall it.
Yeah.
I think we saw. I think we called it together.
Well, certainly in his semi-final yesterday against Pradoy, Shi Yu Qi looking very strong indeed.
Did he win the coin toss yesterday?
He did, and he chose ends.
I think without knowing it in total, I haven't checked his match against Koki Watanabe and his fellow countryman Wang Hongyan, but the results indicate that he's started on this side every single time. Last week in Malaysia, Anas Antonsen won the coin toss five consecutive times and took the title. And if we look at the average point scored by his opponent in second game in this tournament, it is 7.
My goodness.
Service over.
Oh, that's fantastic. Played from such a low, that one, from such a low position.
False.
Yeah, that's a good follow-up from Shi Yu Qi.
5-1.
I've been impressed with Li Cheuk Yiu in this tournament here. I think he's played so extremely well, but I've also been super impressed with Shi Yu Qi, because I feel that his right arm and his racket, I don't think he ever lets go of it. I think he sleeps with it and eats with it and so on. It just seems like one, the racket and the arm, and his shots seem so effortless. It's just like, I mean, not in doubt whether they will come over. I expect every shot he makes to come over. He makes it look so easy.
Yeah. Well, this is an excellent start by Shi Yu Qi.
6-1. it's over.
That's the first one that's been a little loose. And immediately punished by Yu Qi.
That Shi Yu Qi has that extra significance in today's final because he's lost his last five finals, one last week, of course, and four last year. I think it's very important he breaks that losing streak in finals.
I think so too. Because the rest of the game is working so well. The rest of the game, his game has been working so well, so you want to convert it into a tournament win when that happens. But the same could be said for Lee Cheuk Yiu.
Yeah.
Serve is over. Seven, four.
Four encounters since the COVID pandemic, and before the pandemic there were two different editions of Shi Yu Qi, before and after he rolled his ankle in Indonesia Open in 2019. So I think it's interesting to look back on the more like a old.
Oh, that's a big miss.
After he came back from COVID, Shi Yu Qi, he was back in his old good shape, the way I saw it. And he's 3-1 up since then. The only match won by Lee Cheuk Yiu is at the Asia Championships, which was extremely fast playing conditions in United Arab Emirates. But we've also seen how he's developed his game lead during this tournament here to tailor it to a little bit slower playing conditions.
Got net shot, Shi Yu Qi. And the lift was short, but he's on the double service line when he played that smash.
Service over.
That was a lovely, lovely, lovely backhand service return there with good deception on.
Not that it's your bugbear, is it? Forehand service return. Well, that wasn't so bad from Shi Yu Qi, a forehand service return.
No, it was an okay return. It was just easy readable.
10-5.
Yu Qi didn't want the court attendant. Took care of it by his foot.
Quite have the same spring in his step, Lee Cheuk Yiu, today as he did in his previous matches.
Oh, he's played a lot more on court than Shi Yu Qi.
6-10.
Only an hour longer.
Oh.
Yeah, I worked it out this morning.
Not much.
Service over. 11-6 interval.
To the mid-game interval, and the number six seed, Shi Yu Qi, with an 11-6 lead. The last match, which features the only home players, Aranki Reddy and Chetty in the men's doubles. So 11-6 the advantage to Shi Yu Qi.
That's great play on the Chinese.
12-6.
Say, current world number two does look to be so far in almost cruise control. There you are, first of the commentator.
Couple of mistakes there.
12, keep.
But I agree with you. I think we have to commend Sun Jun for the job he's done with both Xu Qi and Li Xifeng. Shot quality.
Happening too often in the early stages.
Continue to try and target it correctly, or is he playing more to the backhand side of the
net shots you'll ever see.
14-10.
Tight, Lee. Tumbling net shot Lee. From Lee. And he just guides that across court.
Yeah.
Wonderful skill.
Yeah. It's a lovely change of pace when he suddenly picks up speed. Lee Cheuk Yiu first moving backwards. Look at that. And then almost always fully committed to the forward movement. Thompson more or less blitzed Shi last week.
It's a wonderful comeback, isn't it?
It is.
Service over. 15-13.
Play we've seen so far here yesterday with Naroka and Lee, and last week with our Zantons, and shows that you have to be good at the net to be a top player.
Lovely, lovely smash. Broke the strings of his racket with that smash that was absolutely plumb on the line.
15.
Look at that. Perfection.
And he's sharper in the attack than Shi Yu Qi.
Six 12 down to 15 all. Missed it.
Service over. 16-15.
From Shi Yu Qi.
17-15.
Yeah, most of his attack has been down the sidelines. They're going for the jamming body attack.
Yeah. Super important rally now, especially for Lee to stay in it.
Yeah.
3-point advantage and 3 points away from the opening game, Shi Yu Qi.
And just moved away just as Lee had caught up with him, and that's sometimes very demoralizing for the player trying to catch up.
Lift is long.
Service over. 16-18.
Oh, he's gone for the body attack again, and a second time it's worked for him.
19-17.
That is a super return of serve.
Service over.
Disguised on the forehand.
A lovely forehand return. A little hold and flick.
Oh, that's nice. That is good variation and good courage from Shi Yu Qi.
20, game point 18.
Because he's used the body attack when things got awfully tight, and there the courage to go down the forehand side, and it's two game point opportunities for the former champion Shi Yu Qi.
Service over.
First is squandered.
Yeah, that was a bit unusual. He's played so well at the net from that 20. Position up until now, Shi Yu Qi.
Another error at the net from Shi Yu Qi. And Lee Cheuk Yiu is back level. 20 all and extra points required until there's a clear 2-point winning margin. Point opportunity for Shi Yu Qi. Did you see that glimpse of Wong Chun Han?
I did.
Lee's coach. And hardly bear to watch.
I'd like to have a pulse meter on Chun Han there.
Third game point.
Attacking opportunity and the two net shots when he first had his game points. That showed to Cheuk Yiu that there's possibilities.
This time he converts. 23-21, the opening game in favour of Shi Yu Qi. Opening game in just under 26 minutes.
分配好啊，还是体力分配好。这个进攻，得分率还是蛮高的。但是呢，你不要想输，想输打死他，你看有个双打线都差点就界外了。还是打完以后，准备上面开人嘛。啊，往前打的好，他就在上面，我就在上面动。在上面动了以后，你看他就快攻和回放就有用了。要不然光回放好回的，不用在上面动，对吧？然后还有什么？
你搞到而家平實之後一過嚟位，再推嚟位。係
啦，你開始要拉板不過當輕嘅嚇，要調整一下。頭先呢一兩粒之後你一起啊，你唔得㗎，你個彈皮冰咗。你落中路中來，咪又上嚟會撳你身體，你要注意呢樣嘢啦。手一嚟揸實，你一嚟打彈。
20 seconds, 20 seconds. Second game, level play.
Well, it turned out to be a thrilling opening game, 23-21, in favour of Shi Yu Qi. He'd look to be well in control. 12-6 up.
Service over.
Well, it's been 14 months and one day since Shi Yu Qi last won a title, the Australian Open of 2022. Five previous finals in the interim period.
And the way he celebrated that first game win, there's no doubt about the hunger to get on the top of the podium again.
1-0.
Pushed it well long.
Service over. 2-1.
No, play on. Fine.
Thank you.
Yeah, look at that, Steve. Yeah. Calm down, calm down.
A lot of adrenaline in the body.
Lovely, lovely shot.
We have to describe the two front corners, forehand and backhand, and that corner there is the one where Shi Yu Qi is a little bit slower, hanging a little bit extra, split second.
Service over.
That's definitely something to incorporate in the game plan if you're each of you. Doesn't mean you can play it all the time, but when you see the right possibilities occur, then that could be the target.
Boy, it's challenging.
He's
right there. And the line judge has called it in.
Yeah, I saw it as clearly in.
I saw it as in too. Oh, that net being made wide.
Yes.
Oh. Nice. And I don't know if you saw that, Steve, there was a little nod of acknowledgement from Lee to his opponent's good shot after this rally. That's nice sportsmanship, isn't it?
Also a clenched fist from Sun Jun. I think we're going to see a bigger mixture of these variety shots in the attacking situation. The slices, the stick smashes, compared to some of the full power smashes we saw in the first game. Because Shi Yu Qi is playing up against the drift here, and his attack doesn't have the same bite.
Five, four.
He shouldn't have the same bite as in the first game. So patience is required.
Four straight points to go into the lead, Shi Yu Qi. Five straight points. Ready to pounce, Shi Yu Qi. And the fact that he was hovering, waiting at the front of the court, I think was the deciding factor that forced Lee Cheuk Yiu into error. What Shi Yu Qi's movement here. Hovering.
Yeah.
Yep. Ready to bounce. Six straight points for the number six seed. Rally. Fabulous rally. to scramble. Shi Yu Qi.
Super play by Li Cheuk Yiu here.
Seven.
Who also played patient. Good save.
Cheek back on hooks.
Beautiful shot.
Suter angle on the smash again. I can tell you he was playing that incredibly well yesterday against Pernoy.
Yeah. And it might work well for him here. We saw yesterday Kuranaoka playing the far side of the court against Lee and applying a more attacking playing style. She got a little extra height to work with.
Seven of the last eight points to Shi Yu Qi. Just wide.
Service over.
They also the sliced shots from Li Cheuk Yiu is also working quite well. You saw that one there landing in front. You see, Shi Yu Qi has to take a step forward. It's not enough just to go to the side.
By a whisker, but if Li Cheuk Yiu is wrong on this challenge, he's got no challenges left in this second game. And that could be costly. Everyone looking towards the giant screen, coaches and players alike. The line, he's got no challenges left.
No,
that's a wonderful call by the line judge.
Service over.
In this challenge, there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, that's okay to have a second opinion on that one. It was the first one. He stood there and he could watch it fall down the line. He might live to regret it.
Just wide.
10-6.
Brilliant.
11-6. Interval.
10 of the last 12 points to Shi Yu Qi.
20 seconds. 11-6.
So the game and 11-6 up, Shi Yu Qi. What an amazing backhand cross-court net shot from Shi Yu Qi. He tried that a couple of times at the end of the opening game, and it didn't work. That one was perfect. Wow. Yeah, did you see the celebration again,
yeah,
Steve?
Yeah.
36.
And, I think that Yu Qi has gotten a lead that's big enough so that he can believe it himself. I don't think he will let the nerves get the better of him.
14-6.
Good play.
Service over. 7-14.
That's going to be super important for each of you, the way I see it, that he can find the back line. I mean, if he can't, then that's okay. Then the possibilities are limited, but he's got to try it. Excellent.
Chi overcommitting.
A-14.
To come forward. Here, once he's pushed in the deep forehand corner, he's overcommitting to look for the net.
A little bit under pressure, playing the clear lead trick, and that's what you can do when you're playing the fast side. And you get a little help.
Straight points. And all of a sudden, it's believable again.
Yeah.
Play.
That's a super, super shot.
11,
acute angle. Very close to the sideline. You don't get much better than this final smash. Look at that. Nigh on perfection. Good defense.
And he has gotten a little tense, Shi Yu Qi. That's a wrong smash, that one.
Well, Shi Yu Qi is calling for the doctor. Surgery after the twisting of the ankle at the Indonesia Open of 2019. is definitely flexing his left ankle. There he is, flexing the left ankle. Yep. That's the one he had surgery on. Oh, he's flexing the right ankle too. Well, I didn't really see when that back injury occurred.
No, I didn't see it either, but he's making some quick movements to his long backhand side. There's really a lot of power to break back there.
12-14.
So six straight points. And 12-14. 1 point in it. 7 straight points. This is extraordinary comeback. Game against Sudirman.
Yeah, and in the first game here, only did win it. Good shot.
Missed it.
He's playing faster now, Cheuk Yiu.
9 straight points.
Yep.
Brilliant! Have you ever seen anything like it? 10 straight points from a game and 6-14 down.
And Shi Yu Qi right now is basically playing full court against front court. He's not playing a lot to the back court of Cheuk Yiu, and he's got to change that. He's got to make the court big, and he's got to do it when he's in a reasonably good position.
Service over.
Brilliant defense.
Fantastic defense.
That's gone wide. What a match.
16-4. Thank you.
Well, he's got no challenges left.
17-16.
I think he would have wanted to challenge that. I saw that as definitely long anyway.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, oof. Clearly long.
Oh, it was a little closer than I had initially thought. Brilliant. My goodness, he got in position quickly to play that straight smash. Points away from the title, Shi Yu Qi. Opportunities for Shi Yu Qi to win his second India Open title.
17.
But Shi Yu Qi wins his second India Open title 6 years after his first. 23-21, 21-17.
Match won by Shi Yu Qi.
A match lasting 54 minutes.
21-17.
Well, he looked to be in all sorts of trouble when he lost 10 consecutive points, having looked to be cruising at 14-6 up in the second game. His run of 5 losses in 5 consecutive finals play comes to an end. And Shi Yu Qi is going to throw his rackets to some of his fans. And that's a lovely moment. Wong Chun Han, coach to Liu Cheuk Yiu, just congratulating Shi Yu Qi. Well, what a dramatic final. Full of drama.
And clearly the best match of the day. Strong comeback by Lee Cheuk Yiu. All credits to him and also to Shi Yu Qi for sort of regrouping and weathering the storm here in the second game.
Absolutely. Confirmation of that scoreline, 23-21, 21-17 in 54 minutes. this the final rally. And finally, after five losses in finals, Shi Yu Qi is the champion. The champion for a second time here at the India Open. Well, that has taken a huge effort. Two finals in 2 weeks in the men's singles discipline.
We now welcome the medal winners to the victory podium for prize presentation ceremony. Please make some noise for runners-up Lee Cheuk Yiu from Hong Kong, China.
Well, Lee Cheuk Yiu has done himself. And his country are proud this week here in Delhi. His first ever final at 750 level. And he's played quite brilliantly throughout, but today was beaten by a better player.
YONEX Sunrise India Open, 2024 men's singles champion. Please put your hands together for Shi Yu Qi, China.
It's been a long wait for Shi Yu Qi. Since his last title, 14 months and one day to be precise, but it was certainly worth the wait. A second title here at the India Open, 6 years after his first.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would request Mr. Vivek Devanga, Chairman and Managing Director, REC, to please present
the medals. The men's singles title at this event.
Request Mr. Vivek Devanga Nayas to please present the mementos. Can I now request Mr. Vivek to please present the stone to the players. Can I now request Mr. Jaswinder Soli, Head of Customers, Digital Marketing, HSBC India, to please present the bouquet to our players.
Well, Shi Yu Qi will consolidate his ranking at number 2 after this week here in Delhi.
Can I now request Mr. Vikram Bhatt, Managing Director, Sunrise Sports India, to please present the mock check. We will now request our dignitaries to come together for a group photograph with our players. I would like to thank our dignitaries for joining us here.
Always a nice touch when the winner invites the beaten finalist onto the top of the podium for photographs. So coming up next, just one more final to come. It's the World Championship gold medalist Kang and Soo from Korea up against the Asian Games gold medalist Ranki Reddy and Shetty from India. Welcome back to finals day here in Delhi at the YONEX Sunrise India Open. Just one more final to come, and it's the only final to have home interest. It is men's doubles, and you don't get any better than this. It is the World Championship gold medalist Kang Bin.